I smell burnt toast.
I thought you were going to read the same one.
I smell burnt toast and I have no control over my leg muscles.
That's fine. That's actually good. It means you're relaxed. Before we jump into this episode, we wanted to let you know that we have a new presenting sponsor, Cash App. Shout out to Cash App for making this episode possible, okay?
Fuck.
Thank you.
Fuck, I wish I fucking thought of Cash App.
And it pays to get paid on Cash App, dude. And thank you to our sponsor, HelloFresh. Okay? For free breakfast for life, go to HelloFresh.com/free almost Friday. One free breakfast item per box while subscription is active. That's free breakfast for life just by going to HelloFresh.com/free almost Friday. HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. And this episode is sponsored by BetterHelp, okay? Never skip therapy day with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/beers. Yeah, that's all caps, beers. Today, to get 10% off your first month, that's BetterHelp, HELP.com/beers. Let's get into the episode.
Hi, guys. Welcome back.
Hey, guys.
We just found out we were recording 5 minutes ago.
I just found out I'm dying.
Of what?
They didn't specify. I also didn't ask.
Am I crazy or is it really dark in here? It does. It feels darker than normal. How do the optics look, Emily? Audio listeners are like, what are they talking about?
Emily, how are the optics?
Looks good on my end.
Jarvis, enhance.
Jarvis is completely in jeans today.
It's
You're denimed out.
Denim smock. Except it's like, it's from a brand that like is newer and it's like a one girl
thing. Reinventing denim.
Yeah, and so she's still working out the kinks, I'm sure. So, like, this is, like, really up my crotch.
Oh.
Oh.
But I still...
Oh, do tell. Let's see. You've got...
If I go like this...
Denim shirt, denim pants.
No, it's a jumpsuit.
Denim shoes, denim socks.
Denim skin.
Yeah, wow. That is a unique look. You've completely sewed denim all over your body.
Room. What do you got? I can't see it.
Some custom little... I picked all the chains on this. Okay, no one cares.
True. How are you, Gus? Fuck, you have sunglasses on?
Here you go, Brenda.
You saw.
Yeah, this is how we hook it up.
Best hands in the state. I was on hands team.
Who's that guy from Signs of the Lambs that skins people?
The lamb? No, I'm just kidding. Wow.
Liam's like, I'll fire one off right now.
Lauren's eating some loud chips outside.
Yeah. Should we bring her in here and humiliate her?
Nah.
Make her feel like small as a bug.
Smaller than that.
Like a rat, like a newt.
Yeah, like a newt.
A newt or like a cork?
I'm the kid in the Matilda that, the little black girl that has newts in jars.
Oh, I don't remember that. Emily, pull that up.
Spiritually and physically, that's how I feel all the time.
Dude, when I was a kid, all I'd do, like me and my brother, would go to the creek, catch newts and tadpoles.
You're down at the creek a lot. You've been down at the creek recently.
I've been down to the creek quite a bit.
What the fuck did you... You looked up kid with newts in a jar.
That's what you just said.
I don't think he said that exactly. What did
you say? Have you seen Matilda?
A long time ago.
Yeah, you gotta rewatch that, dude. Yep. There I am.
Oh, I kind of remember that.
There I am. Yeah, and then the mean lady drinks the newt.
You dressed up as her for Halloween, right?
Yeah. Well, I kind of dress up her.
Would you put on?
What the heck, Liam? How'd you turn on to that?
Something I've been into, dude. How are you? Not good.
I've been better.
Yeah.
My brain's melting.
Yeah.
My heart sits at the bottom of my tummy for most days. I don't feel great. But here I am.
What if I give you like a handful of some dry Honey Nut Cheerios?
Be happy.
Yeah.
Do you have any?
No, but I could get you some today.
I know what you guys are thinking. That's so brave of Will, even though he's feeling down in the swamps. That's brave of him to show up and do the pod with his friend Liam, with his friend Emily. Well, I'm contractually obligated, so here you go. And that's what I'll say about that.
Emily, how was your weekend?
What did I do this weekend? Oh, I was in Miami. It was kind of boring. I went to go to an appointment to get my tonsils taken out.
No!
So I am going to be gone.
Guy who has no idea what tonsils are. It's like a new character. I was actually going to do it for the pod. It's actually a new character. I was going to do it for the pod.
Strong. Strong premise. So you got your tonsils out?
No, so I'm going to get them out, and I'm going to be gone for 3 weeks, so start crying now.
No, Emily, please, no!
Wait, what do you mean you're going to be gone for 3 weeks?
Well, we'll plan ahead for it.
What do you mean?
The heal period is like 2 to 3 weeks.
But you'll be here.
No, I'm going to be getting them out in Miami so that my parents can take care of me.
You're going to be like bedridden for 3 weeks after you get your tonsils out?
I can like do work on the probably the second or third week, but like I'm not going to be in the office. I can't like speak.
Wait, that's like the best way to do an episode then.
Yeah, that'd be like great.
Fuck, you're so right.
And Emily, and you know that me and Liam are giving you a hard time.
He's giving you a hard time.
Because we do like you. We do like when you chime in. So obviously it's just jokes.
That's like our dynamic.
I mean, it's all jokes with Liam.
According to the metrics on this podcast, other people like when I chime in too. Especially when I do my impressions.
Yes, it's more like only when you do your impressions because the little spike was just for the impressions.
Yeah.
In fact, we gave you some homework.
You did.
And maybe we jump right in.
Fire off.
Okay, do you know what? Do you remember? Did we even tell? No, we didn't say it. Emily, Marge Simpson, go.
Oh, you're putting me on the spot. I'm getting a little nervous. Wait, first.
What? it just. Yeah, rat bastard.
Okay, I actually practiced this one with Tanner in the other room, and he helped me out because he's really good at it. And I didn't realize that until I went in there asking for help.
Like he's good at impressions or this specific one?
This specific one. I need to like listen to the one line I was practicing first really quick.
Now, should we just get Tanner in here for a better impression?
Honestly, probably.
Probably. Okay. Honestly, probably.
All right, let's hear it.
Homer.
That's good.
Is that good?
Yeah.
I've never watched the show.
You've never seen The Simpsons?
I've never.
No, I heard it's great.
Fuck you.
I wasn't allowed to watch it as a kid.
What do you mean you weren't allowed to watch The Simpsons?
My dad said it was too inappropriate, so I never watched it. And
The Simpsons is not inappropriate.
I think he just thought it was like...
Yeah, it is. Based on the clips that I looked up for research.
I think it was like a PG-13 show.
How? But...
I'm still not allowed to watch it.
What could you watch when you were a kid? What else were you not allowed to view?
Ed, and Eddie.
My mom did not fuck with that. My dad liked it though, so I could watch it when she wasn't around.
I wasn't allowed to watch SpongeBob either because my dad thought it was too stupid.
What the hell?
But then one day I was homesick. And he turned on the TV and left. And the first channel was SpongeBob. And I was like, I felt like I was doing something so wrong. But I was going to be like, well, he put it on. So I can't get in trouble for this. He put on the channel. And then I watched SpongeBob. And I was like, this is the best show. This is the best fucking show I ever made.
My parents did not like me watching SpongeBob either. They said it would melt my brain.
Well, it melted my brain. And here I am.
Yeah.
I'm here because of SpongeBob. And my life's worse for it.
Damn.
All right, do it. Do your impression.
Okay. I need to like say it a couple times and everyone's gonna be good.
All right, should we plug our ears until you're ready? La 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 la.
Oh, I got it. I got it. Because I recorded myself doing it so I'd remember how to do it.
Homer.
That's better than the first.
Okay, wait.
Homie. Homer, what are you
doing? We forgot how to do it now.
Dude, you're blowing it.
You're blowing it.
Okay,
and you know what's scary is this is.
Oh, homie. Wait, what did he say?
Jesus, you know what sucks is like you've set the bar so high for yourself because the JoJo Siwa.
I know, but that's why I'm cutting it. So don't let me.
No, you can't.
No, Emily.
Yes, that's not fair.
No, Emily, just do it. And if it's
no, Emily, you have to leave it in.
Oh, homie, you're so sexy when you're paranoid.
Bad,
very bad.
Oh, homie,
that's not good.
Oh, homie. Oh, I did it so good earlier.
I bet
play
you did,
the recording.
Man, I wish I was there.
Oh. You're so sexy when you're paranoid.
Sounds about the same. Sounds nothing like Marge Simpson.
Same.
I do Homer. Everything good, okay?
I do it better. You're Give corrupted. Me a line to say.
Say what I just said.
Oh, Homer, you're so sexy when you're paranoid.
You had it up top. You lost in the middle.
Homer. I don't know, Homer. I don't know.
I don't know.
You do it.
I can't.
Exactly.
Nervous?
Nah.
Tanner does a really good impression.
Tanner, get him in here. Hurry, 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 hurry.
What else is going on, dude? I just got back from Hawaii.
Yeah, that's insane.
It was awesome.
Do you have any photos from snorkeling?
No. I snorkeled with sea turtles and shit. It was pretty electric. I thought something horrible was going to happen to me the whole time I was in Hawaii.
Are there sharks out there?
Yeah, tigers. In
here. Tiger sharks?
Yeah.
Those are the most dangerous.
Yeah.
Okay, you have to do your, Emily says you have a really good Marge impression.
I did mine and I didn't do a good job.
And she fucking blew it.
She botched it. Yeah.
Wait, let's hear hers.
I can't do it anymore. I got
nervous. No, do it.
Oh, homie. You're so sexy when you're paranoid.
Did you tell, you told her that
oh,
was good?
Oh, homie.
I told her that was a line.
Did you
show?
No, he said I was doing a good job.
I thought she was doing a pretty good job. You should hear the recording she made.
We did.
I showed it. And
you guys were impressed
by it. No, it's the same thing she just did.
Yeah. Well.
Okay, do it. Go.
Oh.
See, now we get nervous.
Hold on. No, no one's nervous. We'll cut it if you don't like it.
Okay, cool. Oh, perfect.
See, don't you forget? Like,
what's the line? It's like,
oh, homie.
That's great.
You're so sexy when you're paranoid.
Dude, that's excellent. That's so good.
Oh.
When did you learn you could do that?
When did you come in and ask?
Literally today.
The bookends of your impression were perfect.
It's the middle.
The middle is a little bit, but the bookends were like from the show. Well, all right. Thank you, Tanner.
Excuse. Great. Thanks, Tanner. Thanks for well, there's no camera on you. Maybe next time we'll get it.
All right. Homework for next week, Emily. Let's say... I want to do someone with an accent.
Let's ask the bugs to give Emily the homework.
Ooh, yeah.
Guys, comment below and say which impression you'd like to hear Emily do on next week's episode.
And I really hope that you all comment the announcer from Love Island, because I'm really good at that one. Okay.
All right. Yeah, anyways, tiger sharks.
Do you have any photos from your trip of the snorkeling?
Mm-mm.
You didn't bring your waterproof GoPro?
Mm-mm. No. Dude, I was snorkeling with sea turtles, though, just in the wild.
I know.
Two sea turtles, and I didn't touch them. I didn't do anything to them.
Were you not allowed to?
Not allowed to.
I would have been reaching inside grabbing their eggs.
I wanted to.
When I was in Miami, shout out to me.
You weren't in Miami, you were in Fort Lauderdale.
And how are you?
You've been good.
Have you been good lately?
Yep.
Awesome. How was your weekend?
It's great.
Oh, that's awesome. I'm actually like so psyched to hear that.
Cool.
So when I was in Miami.
Fort Lauderdale.
Awesome, man. How are you?
Continue.
Heck yeah. So when I was in Miami.
Fort Lauderdale. Sorry.
When I was in the Miami area. Good.
Good.
Happy, Emily?
Yeah, because actually, it's like an hour.
That's awesome. Well, I couldn't afford to go to Miami because my parents didn't buy a condo there. They didn't buy a vacation home there.
It's not a vacation home. It's their only
home. Oh, okay, sorry.
I went to Fort Lauderdale. After we graduated from UMass, me and all my pals went. My buddy got a tattoo that said UMass on his thigh, and it got infected immediately.
Did he get sick?
He didn't get sick. But
he got sick in Fort Lauderdale.
Come on.
Oh, fuck. Can I tell my story? It was really interesting. When I was on the beach there, they had all these little places roped off. It said, do not interfere. This is a sea turtle nest all over the beach.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, of course, I just dug my jaw in the sand and I pushed through, like scooping in all the sea turtle eggs. It was like a shark above the water.
Your stomach was just like a bunch of balls in it.
My gum's full of sand. Can't get them out.
Sea turtle burst out of your belly like the alien.
Well, I hope not. Okay, so a lot of people wanted to hear your thoughts on this. Emily, pull up that first article.
Hear my thoughts on it?
Yes. Because you're a very staunch RFK far-right supporter.
Fuck.
Right.
Is he far right?
No, you are.
Oh.
Okay, so RFK admits to dumping a bear carcass in Central Park. Have you seen this?
No. He's going from crows to this?
He's going from worms?
Last I heard of him, he was just being friends with crows. I haven't heard from him.
Well, this is the worm in his head. He didn't do this.
Okay.
I was taking a group of people to Falcon up in Goshen, New York, up in the Hudson Valley. And I was supposed to meet them there at like maybe 8 or 9. I was driving up maybe, you know, really early, like 7.
Is that Roseanne Barr?
Woman in a van in front of me hit a bear and killed it. A young bear.
Is it?
Yeah.
So I...
Well, she's far right, isn't she?
And I picked up the bear and put him in the back of my van because I was going to skin the bear. And it was very good condition. And I was going to put the meat in my refrigerator. And you can do that in New York State. You can get a bear tag for a roadkill bear.
He sounds like he's talking into a fan.
We went walking, and I had the bear in my car. And then we had a really good day, and we went late. We were catching a lot of game, and the people really loved it. So we stayed late, and instead of going back to my home in Westchester, I had to go right to the city because there was dinner at Peter Luger's Steakhouse. And at the end of the dinner, it went late, and I realized I couldn't go home. I had to go to the airport, and the bear was in my car, and I didn't want to leave the bear in the car because that would have been bad. So then I thought, you know, at that time, this was the little bit of the redneck in me. There'd been a series of bicycle accidents in New York. They had just put in the bike lanes.
This is how I worry I sound when I'm telling stories.
No, that's how I sound when I'm telling a story.
Yes, but that's how I worry I sound.
Yeah, I mean, so like, what's, is it just, how much longer do we have in this?
That was
3 minutes? All right, so what does he do? He just dumps the bear?
I don't know, I haven't seen
this. Yeah, so he apparently dumps the bear in Central Park.
And now everyone's upset?
Well, yeah, because there's a whole other thing of him. There was a photo of him where he barbecued a dog carcass.
What? He's a guy. He's a fucking guy.
I'm still, no.
Oh, that's brutal.
That's a dog carcass?
That's what people are saying.
What the fuck is this guy up to? He's falconing? By the way,
what does that mean?
I thought falconing is when you just wear that glove and then you like let the falcon.
Oh, like actual falconing.
That's what he said. He said I was taking my friends falconing, which that's relatable. I get that.
That is relatable.
I understand that.
Ooh, is that your RFK impression?
Yeah. Yeah.
What
was falconing?
Why does he sound like that?
I don't know.
No, I'm not trying to be funny. It's clearly like a medical thing.
No, he's old.
Yeah, but like
I know
old
people that sound like
yeah.
That.
A lot of old people that I know sound like that.
A lot of old people you know? How many old people do you know?
Well, I feel like Joe Biden sounds like that.
No. That's in, you know? I'm talking about how many old people do you know personally?
I don't know that many old people. But my grandpa kind of sounds like that. Papa.
Look up, why does RFK's voice, it'd be the first thing.
Spasmodic dysphonia. It's a chronic neurological voice disorder and a focal laryngeal.
It's just going to take another quick minute. Give us 60 fucking seconds. Take
another Quint Brint.
Quint Brint to talk about Cash App. Okay, you probably know by now, Cash App is a place to send people money. Like when you need to settle up with your buddies after a crazy night in the town with someone and your buddy's missing. And you guys got to pool your money together, hire a PI, and find your missing buddy. You do that on Cash App.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're here to tell you that Cash App actually has a lot more to offer than just helping you find your missing friends and sharing money and all that stuff.
That's a really good point, Liam, because Cash App is a faster, simpler way to manage your money. Okay, you can start saving with as little as $1. There are no minimum balance requirements. With Cash App Savings, you get the most from your money with no hidden fees and no account fees. Sounds too good to be true,
but it's
probably it is.
No, man, Cash App makes it easier for you to save money with high yield savings.
Yep.
And I know what that means. So you can save up for the things you love, like parachutes, windsurfs, polarized sunglasses.
Honestly, for me, I just sit and hoard my money like a dragon.
That's also something you could do on Cash App.
I love anything. I wouldn't spend my money on anything.
And you don't have to, okay? Cash App gives you control of your money, so you can hoard it like a dragon, do whatever you want. Get control of your money like I get control of the souls of the millions of ants on Earth. I control their souls, and I decide who gets to live in eternity with me in heaven and who gets their souls sucked down into hell.
I'm going to save up all my money on Cash App, and then when Liam's dad can't pay for his house and the bank forecloses on it, I'm going to buy it from the bank and demolish it, and I'm going to bring Liam there.
I can't wait. A lot of bad memories in that house, so you'd be doing me a favor. Joke's on you. Guys, download the app today and take control of your finances with Cash App. Join the millions who already manage their money with Cash App and start saving today. Make the most out of your money. It pays to get paid on Cash App, and let's get back into the episode. You know what I want to talk to you about? I've been getting real into giants.
What do you mean?
Just the existence of giants. And do you know that...
Like in fantasy books?
No, in real life, in the earth we live on now. There's
Go on.
Have you ever heard
I will of, entertain this.
Have you ever heard of the Kandahar giant?
The canned...
Look, yes, please look that up. Just look up Afghanistan giants. But apparently, in 2002, in that range, some U.S. military men killed a giant in Afghanistan. And the stories out there, and there's a lot of other stories from this hidden.
All right, hidden let's look up articles, not renderings. Thoughts?
They're all on Reddit.
Reddit's the most reliable source of information on the internet.
Look up. So that's one thing. And then look up, I think it's the Solomon Islands. Giants. Yep, first thing. Yeah. There's this YouTube channel called Wartime Stories, I believe it is. I'll fix that if I'm wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But apparently, when Japan invaded the Solomon Islands, you know, just set up a base there, Japanese soldiers were pushing further and further into the Solomon Islands, deep inside this unexplored jungle, and they started getting fucked up. Eaten alive by these giants. And the Solomon local tribes all have lore about just fucking man-eating giants.
All right, where are the fossils?
There's no fossils or anything? I mean, there are giant bones that have been hidden by the Smithsonian.
What do you mean?
Look up Smithsonian.
All right, I need you to, when you talk to me, to not... Talk to me like it's a fact.
This is all real, dude. I don't do a little bit of research.
I don't have to do research to know giants aren't real.
Giants are real, dude.
Okay, but this is like...
Nephilim.
What?
It's in the Bible.
Is this like a conspiracy thing?
Technically, yes, but I'm all on it now.
Did Alex Jones tell you this?
No, this is not an Alex Jones thing.
Liam?
Yeah, of course they're going to say that.
What are they going to say?
That it's not real.
Internet hoax.
It's bullshit, dude. I'm pretty.
Dude, I can't. Dude, when you have. You're going to be like that grandpa on Facebook that's just reposting shit that just isn't true, like AI generated images, and your grandkids are going to make fun of you.
No, not me.
Yeah.
This is. Dude, no. When I'm a grandpa, I'm going to be validated by all this shit because they're going to realize that giants are real and some of them still exist in cave systems.
No, when you're a grandpa, your daughter in law is going to. Beg your son, can we please do my parents' house for Thanksgiving this year?
Well, that's because I'll be living in like more of just like this mud mound. I've dried out a bit of a Patrick Star mud mound.
What do you think that these giants look like?
I think they look...
Have you seen Scavenger's Reign?
Yes, but I haven't finished the first season.
Fuck!
No, they're like 8 to 13 foot tall giants with red hair and six fingers.
Okay.
How do we know this though? Like if we don't have fossils.
Just, you know.
No, I am not
It's the history.
I'm not asking to debunk you. I want to know, like, I would actually love to look at this like information you're reading.
I'll send, dude,
because I love this shit.
Go on YouTube. Guys, everyone watch these YouTube videos. Go Wartime Stories. This channel's sick. I was ripping this on the flight. Yeah. Solomon Island giants, fucking
giant snakes. Does he just do all giant stuff?
He does a lot of shit, but a lot of it's giants for sure. Dude, it's real. These are real stories. They're real tales. They're
this is like oral history passed down?
Yes. But do
47 minutes.
Yes. You should watch the whole thing.
And you watched this on your flight?
Yeah, I watched all of these. The Choctaw, dude, the Choctaw one's crazy. So apparently in the late 1800s, after the Trail of Tears, when they moved...
The casino? Choctaw?
Is that a casino?
It's a casino in...
Well, the tribe. I'm speaking of the tribe.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. We're both speaking of the tribe.
Yes. But the Choctaw, they were living in Mississippi, Alabama, that region, Trail of Tears. They got moved to Oklahoma, and they were living in this new, you know, place in Oklahoma, and these giant Bigfoot creatures started jacking their livestock, and so they didn't know what it was, and then they started jacking their women and children. So they hunted them down. They killed all these Bigfoot.
So Bigfoot is supposed to be just one of these guys.
I think there's two different things. I think they're all probably from the same species, but I think some of them are more fucked up than others. I think some of the giants are probably more human than others, and then there's some that are just more Bigfoot fucking.
See, I need shit like this to be real. I need something that gets me excited.
This shit, I feel, I'm all in on giants right now. I can't.
Like,
I can't.
Where everything's already like, besides the ocean, everything's already explored.
Not. There's still some fucking wilderness out there that we have not fully explored.
Where?
Solomon Islands. Where the giants exist.
Dude, I'd be the happiest guy on the planet if
you think we've explored all of the fucking North America. Canada's huge.
Yeah, I think we have.
We've walked through that entire forest and taken account of everything.
I mean, not like every little bug and leaf and rock.
Exactly.
Emily, look at how much of Earth is unexplored.
All the cave systems?
Well, yeah, cave systems for sure we haven't.
Oh, wow.
Huh.
Oh, how's excluding that? Dry land.
Huh. Dude, we have not explored all the Earth. That's fucking crazy to say that. Giants are out there.
How much of Earth's land is explored? How much of Earth's... Get this fucking Google AI bullshit out of my way.
70%.
That's a lot out there, dude.
Or no, as most of it is under the sea. No, I'm trying to...
Yeah, I need to know just Earth, because like the ocean we've explored, like, none of. And I think that's you and I's next job, is figure out what's down there.
I was thinking this on my flight, because when I was looking at the water and I didn't have my sunglasses on, I couldn't really see through the waves. And then when I put on some polarized shades, mm-hmm. I could see through.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if there's something we're going to invent soon that we'll be able to just see like through all of that special glasses that move light in a way that lets you see all the way through water down to the floor. It just takes out water. You can just see the fucking ocean. Like, you can just see things moving without having the water interfering. I think that'll probably exist.
I don't think so, because it's the light at a certain point. It's so, like, light just doesn't reach down there.
I know, but we got to invent something that we could just, you know, fly in.
I'm saying you and I could do that.
We could.
We take all the money we get from Cash App, shout out Cash App, from sponsoring this pod, and we invest that into exploring the ocean. Shout out Cash App.
Like, I think LiDAR is going to improve to the point where we can just fly a drone over shit and just see exactly what's going on all over the place.
Well, the problem is, guys, did you hear that the guys behind OceanGate?
What the hell is that?
Probably new guys. OceanGate, the submarine that imploded.
Oh.
I think they're doing another one. And the guy's like, we're doing this to prove that that was a once in a, you know, we know what we're doing. That was a boo-boo.
Who are they going to send out there?
Yeah. Guys like me and Liam.
Yeah.
Guys like me and Liam that really want to see like coral.
And don't care
coral's
about dying.
Crazy.
And don't care about nothing that we are. Look it up, OceanGate. Again, would be the funniest story in the history of.
You know what the other thing I want to invent is? You know how you can't carbon date rocks?
Yes. Yes, of course. I knew that.
I feel like there's got to be a new way we can date rocks.
So
we could date the fucking stones on the pyramids and shit.
Yeah.
There's got to be a way to carbon date rocks. Or not carbon date it, just date rocks.
Okay, I don't think I ever fully processed how many stones are actually in the pyramids.
Jarvis, how many stones are in the pyramids?
Take a guess. Don't look.
2 million? And all of them? Or just
let's say all of them.
The ones in Egypt?
Yeah. 2.3, good guess.
Shit. Fuck yeah, dude.
That is mind-boggling. Each one of those weighs a couple tons.
Yeah.
Can we get the
I don't understand how that's
to the pyramids.
What's up?
Can we get Freddy Beers to send us to the pyramids?
We should do our pod in the pyramid.
Dude, I see a ton of videos though of guys going to the pyramids to explore, walk around, and it's just like Venice Beach where guys are trying to hand you CDs.
Yeah, and you spit on them and you say no.
What? Jason, I walked in. Jason had a signed CD on the
No.
And I go,
Did he get got by?
He got got. And I
What's
was
the
like,
guy's name? King.
I don't know. There's a bunch of fellas out there doing that.
Oh, there's one guy that got me. His name was like King something. And he hands me a CD and I go, okay, thanks, man. I'll check it out. And he goes, I've got YouTube too. And I'm like, all right, thanks, dude. And he's like, whoa, where are you going? I'm like, what? He's like, that's $20. And I'm like, I don't want this. I'm not paying for this. And he goes, I just signed it. Now I can't sell it. And I was like,
yeah,
no.
It's
get fucked.
But now I have the CD. You want to listen to it soon?
You want to go grab it? Do we have a CD-ROM?
No,
a CD
player? It's at my apartment.
We should do a bonus listening.
To listen to the Venice Scam.
We should do our Needle Drop Anthony Fantano review.
Did you buy the CD, Will?
No.
You said you got.
Yeah, because he like
lured you into the
car. Yeah, he lured me. I got lured.
Okay, speaking of Venice people luring, you know our favorite man on this street, or my personal
yes
man on the street, and won't get more details. Just
is it the
yes? They did you see that made a shirt with his design on it because he went in there and stole a shirt and he was like, so they made a wanted shirt with his like drawing on it and they go up to him and they're like, we're looking for this guy, have you seen him? And he goes, no.
Where is this a store on the street?
Yeah.
Sorry. So this guy walked in and stole a shirt
and they decided to make a t-shirt design with his like a drawing of him stealing something from the store and they're selling it there for like $60. So they made a video clip of like him stealing it and then selling the shirt. And they even have a little figurine of him.
Can I see this?
What do you think the...
Yeah, I wonder if these guys know how much lore they have in other people's lives. Like, I know lore about him. You remember Hot Rod?
Yeah.
We have lore about Hot Rod. He has no idea.
That's true. What do you think the pyramids were for? What do you think their purpose was? Emily, what do you think the pyramids were for?
I'm trying to think.
I honestly, like, don't know.
The pyramids are a monument to man's arrogance.
I feel like...
Damn, did I just come up with that? Did that just come out of my fucking mouth? What the fuck?
Like, nobody...
Did I really just fucking say that?
No one these days would ever build something like this.
Wrong.
Would you?
Yeah, just built a Lego TIE fighter the other day.
That's true.
It's like the same shit. It is way fucking harder.
And the fact that
they're not like
they're
you
underwater.
Can't walk inside them, can you?
They used to be gold.
They were.
Or the tip was gold.
Tip was gold, but the outside of it was all marble. So it was white and then gold tips. See that one? Left. The white one with the...
Kind of reminds me of that poem, Ozymandias.
That one.
Kind of reminds me of that poem, Ozymandias.
Read the poem.
Yeah. Like, just like talking about it, quoting it. What is that guy? Fake or real? Dude, Mr. Beast should build the pyramids.
That'd be sweet.
I think Mr. Beast is going to be the first guy to freeze his body successfully, come out on the other end.
Guys, I'm taking a quick break. As you know, this show is sponsored by BetterHelp, okay? And your schedule is packed with kids' activities, big work projects, and more. It's easy to
let
your priorities...
You're never going to have kids. What are you talking about?
I'm going to have a huge family, and I'm going to have... My family's going to be like the Duggars, except for none of them will become pedophiles.
You're never going to have a family.
They'll all be Christians, and they'll dress in long dresses and slacks, but none of them will become pedophiles, and I'll have eight of them, or however many Duggars there are. I'll double it. But guys, whenever you feel like you have no time for yourself, which is all the time, honestly, you got to take time to work on your mentals, and BetterHelp can help you do that. So give BetterHelp a try, okay? If you're thinking of starting therapy... Just fill out a brief questionnaire and get matched with a licensed therapist and switch therapists at any time for no additional charge, okay? Never skip therapy day with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/beers today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/beers.
Apparently, I've never done therapy before.
And another word from HelloFresh.
Guys, there's always new flavors with HelloFresh. You can explore an ever-changing menu of 50 recipes to choose from every week. You just pick your meals that you like, your delivery date, and it shows up at your door. It is that simple. You know, if you're too busy, you don't have enough time to cook dinner, or you don't have enough time to get breakfast, okay? HelloFresh makes it easy, okay, at an affordable price.
I just had my first HelloFresh meal the other day. I had two. They were so good. I had a pasta with incredible meat sauce, was amazing. And then I had a chicken cutlet with some mashed potatoes.
You had a chicken cutlet?
I did.
Meanwhile, I'm over here eating pretzels and Capri Sun for dinner because I don't have HelloFresh.
That's what I did before HelloFresh. And I truly felt like an adult man when I was doing my little instructions. They make it very simple for guys like us.
Mm-hmm.
And I did it. I said, oh, I have all my ingredients
here.
Did
they use pictures?
Yes.
Do they actually?
Yes.
That's awesome.
It's so easy. Thank God. But I felt awesome. I was taking pictures of it and like sending it to people pretending that I did it all by myself.
I've had HelloFresh before, but my big HelloFresh box is coming soon.
I need more. I'm already out. Fresh. I already crushed mine. Guys, for free breakfast for life, go to HelloFresh.com/freealmostfriday. One free breakfast item per box while subscription is active. That's free breakfast for life just by going to HelloFresh.com/freealmostfriday. HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. Let's get back into the episode.
Do you want to see my cracker?
Yeah.
Play it, bitch.
Hey.
Spin that shit, bitch. No, in like an endearing way. So this is one of the saddest things I've ever seen.
Man throws tantrum after allegedly losing $50,000 in a casino. What do you mean allegedly?
Oh, by the way, this is Emily. This is your personal reminder to add in the voice cracker theme song because last week you didn't do it.
Uh-oh.
No, Emily.
Except for me.
Hashtag cancel Emily.
Yeah, dude. Can we cancel Emily?
Look, guys, get that going in the chat. Cancel Emily. You'd get real canceled if you showed that YouTube video.
For sure.
Actually, no, you wouldn't.
Crazy. No,
but
no.
you'd get some flack.
Yeah, dude. Emily's got an old YouTube video out there that's buck wild.
I often think about what would happen if I went on Love Island. Like, if there's anything I
can. You often think about that?
Yeah, I want to go on, but I keep weighing the positives and the negatives. Like, I feel like.
How would you get on that show?
I don't know. Apply and maybe like find someone.
Emily
who has a connect.
Emily, I don't think you'd be able to handle that show.
That's why I'm trying to like weigh the positive.
I don't think that there's any world where they would make you look good.
There's no way if a camera was on you for 24 hours, you'd look
because good. We know the lovely, wonderful Emily Binder. We know the character both on screen and off screen of Emily Binder. They would not make you look good.
Why?
Because that's their job.
They don't really make people look bad unless they do something bad.
Then how come all of the clips I've ever seen online are people looking bad?
I've never seen. I watch every episode of it, the whole show.
All of my clips
unless they like fuck over their friend or the guy they're seeing, which I wouldn't be doing.
And those are the clips that go the most viral.
What happens in the show? So it's
it's everyone on there is looking for love.
Mm-hmm. Are you? Are you looking for love or
looking for love
or fame?
Emily's looking for love in all the wrong places.
I know.
Sewers, tunnel systems, old
windmills.
Old windmills, old silos with a bunch of grain in them.
Mm-hmm.
Digging through grain.
Cornfields.
Emily pokes a hole in a silo and just like sifts through the grain and mm-hmm. shit. Old telephone poles that squirrels and chipmunks have turned into like the radiation mm-hmm. chambers with all the acorns mm-hmm. that fall out. Where else is Emily looking for love?
Abandoned factories.
Trenches, just like old trenches from World War I and
new II. New trenches for the next war.
Yeah. Just the field of Gettysburg.
Yeah. Where else?
Where else are you looking for love?
You were saying all that, right?
Not on the dating apps because I deleted them.
Why?
I deleted all my dating apps.
What?
I had a moment. I had like a drunk cry moment like 2 weekends ago and I deleted all the apps and I haven't re-downloaded them. Also, like I don't really message people on there or like I'm not good at responding and like, unless it's someone I know I would be really excited about, I'm not going to answer, and there's never anyone on there.
Who's someone you'd be really excited about?
Just someone who's, like, completely my type, like, I guess.
A guy named Seth with dreads.
Yeah, you would like it.
White guy named Seth with dreads.
Yeah.
Really skinny.
Super skinny.
Literally lives on a longboard.
Used to play the bass clarinet. Used to play all the instruments from Hereditary.
I feel like you guys like have gotten a gauge of like what my type is. Like
I just like
I just
horrible.
We just like, listed horrible. It.
I like dark hair and
it's you know what it is? It's guys that beat women.
Apparently, yeah.
Apparently.
No, that is not my type. You
apparently like, it is.
It just so happened that I met a guy at a bar who beats women and I knew
that's crazy.
Dude. Who else? What else is your type? I'm just trying to think of
I like dark hair, and if I'm really lucky, they'll also have like
Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz.
Guys whose top teeth connect to their bottom teeth.
Guy who's got the extra tooth on the top of his gums.
Ooh.
Cleft lips. Gauges. Guys with gauges.
Guys who do this in photos.
Ew, I hate that.
Well, then why do you keep going after him?
Yeah. No, I don't.
You're a sucker for a septum piercing. We know that.
Yes, that is true.
Septum piercing?
Yeah. Nipple piercing. She loves a guy with a good nipple piercing.
I have a heart piercing.
You do?
Helps regulate my blood.
Anyways, let's play this video.
Play
you're about to say something else. Dark hair.
Dark hair.
Dark eyes, black like a shark.
His hair grows out of his head back into his body.
Mm-hmm.
off camera.
Sort of like a ram's horn that gets stuck in his brain.
Sure, correct.
Off camera, we are continuing the Love Island conversation because I actually really do want to go on there. My favorite show.
That'd be great for us. That'd be awesome.
How fun would that be if you guys have like weekly recaps of every episode?
It'd be fucking awesome. I'm just saying they wouldn't make you look good.
But I would have to have like Elise come on and be like the third host so that like you can't be too mean.
We wouldn't be mean at all.
Yeah. I don't think we...
Everything about the show, you'd be like, I can't believe they did that to her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not being mean to you. That would be like, I know Emily and I know what how the producers are trying to frame you.
I watch the show, and they're not frame. They don't frame anyone. Maybe they do.
Emily. Producers, I'm not saying all of them do this, but on shows like that, their job is to go around with a camera and basically incite people, like stir the pot, mm-hmm. and get reactions and paint an interesting story. Like that's their entire job.
Okay, well then I can come on here afterwards and tell my truth.
Does someone win?
Yeah.
How do you win?
If you fall in love.
If like you people vote the couple that is like most, they just like their favorite couple at the end. And then at the end, whenever the couple wins, there's two envelopes and one person gets to pick an envelope and then the other gets the other envelope. And one of them has $100,000 and the other has zero. And if you get the $100,000 one, you pick keep or split with your significant other on the show. Everyone's always picked split because they're like actually in love. But yeah, that's how it ends.
Now I know.
I didn't follow that.
No, nobody's following it.
You win $100,000.
There you go.
But yeah. You split it with your couple on the show.
I think there should just be like an MTV True Life of Emily.
This is basically it.
Cracker time.
Cranker.
Cracker of the week. Cracker of the week.
Okay, back to man throwing a tantrum after allegedly losing 50K.
This, I gotta be honest, this one's just sad. There's nothing really here to laugh at. I couldn't believe this.
I did not give a f- because I will do whatever it takes to fight for the people that I fight for. And I wish that I could have voiced this in a different way so everybody can understand it.
Get this guy on Broadway.
It doesn't matter. Because I was here and I said it. I told you and you and all you
people. Yeah, it's a guy at the end of his rope.
If this wasn't so fucking sad.
Oh my God, my heart is
broken. I know. It's like... Dude, that's why I fucking hate, like, I fucking hate going to Vegas so much.
I was gonna ask, do you guys think you could, like, get addicted to gambling?
Nope. I've never...
No, like, betting on sports? Yes.
Yes.
Going to a casino? No. Every time I go to a casino, I don't like it.
I just don't understand, like, bachelor parties that are at Vegas. It's, like, to me, like, the saddest place on the planet. I have never had fun there. You have to spend money. And the whole time, it's, like... Everything is so fake and it's so blatantly fake that you can't even like trick yourself into thinking there's any sort of substance to it.
Yeah, I completely agree. I recently downloaded a solitaire app where you get like money if you like win games, but like you obviously only really get like a good amount of money if you deposit money. But like I'm never going to deposit money in the app.
Yeah.
I've been winning like 5 cents at a time and I'm up to $10. So
not bad.
I do. On that note, I do want to say though, I do love sports gambling. Like I can just download an app and bet on anything.
But
that is a simple pleasure in life.
I do think that that's more skill and knowledge based than like luck. Whereas like,
yeah, I guess I'm specifically talking about going and playing like roulette and poker and, yeah,
like if I'm really good at something, like I'm obviously good at solitaire because I've won $10.
Yeah,
like, then I'll bet on it.
What are some things you wish you could gamble on that you can't?
Love Island.
I bet you could.
I'm so good at predicting who gets voted off next, and like, But I did get the winners wrong, which is just insane.
Do they have a pool at the house?
Yeah, it's like a whole villa.
I feel like Emily would poop in the pool on Love Island.
Yeah.
And they'd have to like empty the
pool. All the guys would jump in, drop jaw, and swim through.
You think? Yeah. I think I'm picturing Emily like walking around blaming it on other women. Because obviously they'd be like, I don't know. You try to blame the poop on someone else.
I would totally be the bitch that would like fart and blame it on someone else.
I would gamble on that though.
That I would poop in the villa.
I ever tell you a story with my buddy? We were at a house party and he went upstairs to take a shit and he
didn't. Oh yeah, you told me.
Cool.
Well, he didn't tell me.
That's a new character I'm working on. Did I ever tell you that story? Yeah.
Yeah, you cut me in half. I felt like Darth Maul. Just falling down that whatever chamber he was falling down.
Yeah, you told me that one.
That really stung.
Have you ever been? People are pretty nice about it usually to me. They say, oh yeah, I remember you telling me that one. Rather than, yeah, you've told it 5 times.
Yeah.
So are we good?
So can I hear the story?
What is that? Are you trying to silence me?
I'm trying to take your skin off. Like they do in Deadpool 3, which I haven't seen, but I've seen it all on fucking TikTok already.
Oh, I saw Challengers this weekend. That's what I watched on the plane instead of Giants videos.
All right. I don't know why you said it like that.
All right. You got to tell your story, though.
It's actually like quality content.
But my friend went upstairs into the third story of this house to take a shit as far away as he could from the party. And there was no water. The toilet wasn't functioning. So he just took a shit in basically like a toilet that would be at Home Depot. It's not even connected to the water. It's just sitting there. And he came downstairs and told me. And then a girl went upstairs and came downstairs. She was like, oh, shit. In the toilet upstairs, that is a man's shit. And then she had pictures of it, and she was showing my friend pictures of his own shit, and he was going, that's fucking wild. I can't believe someone would do that to you. Got away with it.
There was a viral TikTok.
And guess what? And guess what? He's a Marine now. I think he's in the Army. He just finished basic training.
I don't know why we did this. This is there's nothing funny about this. It's just mean. But we would go... everyone in like from Dallas, like their the destination to do like spring break was Seaside, and me and my friend invited me to go with his family and like a bunch of the other kids that go. No one from my school, but there was this one girl who's like, everyone stays at villas that are in like this collective area near the beach. We're all hanging out at this one girl's villa, and she left, and she was like, okay, I'll meet you guys there, just close the door on your way out. And for some reason we all decided to like poop in their toilet, like the Casey Rocket thing. Mm-hmm. And it was like 5 people did a victory lap, and the poop was like coming out of the toilet. She was staying with her parents, and so when they came back, it was like poop reaching above the seat.
Oh.
I'm like, there was no reason to be doing that,
dude.
It was like a prank, but also like, I don't know. But I remember going first so that I didn't have to deal with like Casey's situation.
Well, I love that you reflected back on last week's episode. Everyone, go listen to the Casey Rocket episode if you haven't already. Proceed, Liam.
When I was in like 8th grade, me and my buddies were hanging out at my friend's house, and we clogged the toilet upstairs so bad, and then the water started coming through and dripping into the kitchen, and... we just started running around and like laughing and taking videos of it and screaming poop water through the ceiling. And his mom came down. It was not as funny to her because we ruined her home.
Yeah.
And she, and rightfully so, I remember being like stunned that she was that angry and then not stunned at all because I thought, you know, this is appropriate.
There's water coming through the ceiling. Water, poop water.
That is bad.
Yeah.
I had a buddy who took me on his family's like very expensive vacation to this resort in Cabo. We got so drunk. We were sharing a room. It's one of those rooms where the bathtub was just kind of like in the middle of the bathroom. It was really big. It was like the centerpiece. And I think I had fallen asleep maybe. And he had gotten really hammered and wanted to take a bath. And like we just woke up. There was like 2 inches of water in our room in this very expensive resort because the bathtub had just been running. And so we spent like hours just throwing towels down and rinsing them in. And I think we got a complaint that there was like water dripping, and we were like, I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
God, dude, nothing.
Not my fault though.
Oh, fuck.
But that's a, Very expensive bill.
Yeah.
Very expensive.
Dude, my buddy was at his...
Plumbing, who knew? Who knew that junk was expensive?
Who knew? My buddy was on vacation with his girlfriend's family one time. New relationship, kind of the first or second time he's meeting her family. And he said at dinner, like in the house, he was just like, wave of diarrhea hit him. He was like, I gotta get to the bathroom right now. And he went to the bathroom and all they had was paper towels to wipe with in there. And he couldn't be like, I gotta go ask them for where the toilet paper is. Mm-hmm. He's like, I'm just gonna wipe with paper towels, which is not where you wanna be. So he said he was like getting him wet in the sink and then wiping his ass and putting him in there. But it was just one of those things where he had to use six or seven paper towels, flushed it, thin clogs. And he's like, water comes back up and it goes down. He just thinks, all right, I'm going to give it one more flush and see what happens.
Ooh, that's always the worst.
Dude, and he's just watching it and the water's rising and rising. And he's just going, it's about to overflow. And it just starts overflowing. And at this point, he's been in the bathroom for 20 fucking minutes. No. The family's eating dinner.
No.
Watching it overflow is the worst pain.
Dude, just the acceptance of like,
This I'm going to have to grab towels. I'm going to have to get poop water all over me. Like, I'm going to have to get other people involved now.
That's what my brain would black out, as if like a tiger was about to attack me. You know, it would just shut down. And you just go unconscious because your body's just like, it's better you're not awake for this. I'd just pass out in the bathroom. They'd come in, I'd be covered in poop water.
Oh my God.
Just because this has happened to me before, but not in that stressful of a situation where the water's coming up and you just go, this is it.
What'd he do?
I think he just started to like clumping up, and he was in there for probably a half hour and then just walked out soaked. The stink's probably stuck to his fucking jeans.
I would have just gone downstairs and
I would have left.
I would have killed every single person in that room.
Yeah.
What's that TV show where the guy at the end of episode one kills everyone at the barbecue?
Oh,
Hunt or something?
Hunters or something like that.
I would have done that.
Yeah. The girl runs out. So, he clogged the toilet.
I said, you had to fuck it up for me. Yeah. I spent so long dating this woman.
Oh my God. God.
Hey, Liam, should we do your crock?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, technically it's a cranter now.
Cranter.
Dude, me and Will were doing an audition the other day and I farted so bad we almost had to stop.
I have it on camera.
Do you really?
Yeah.
We gotta find need to see that. Can we put it in the F or no?
Yeah, let me pull it up right now.
Dude, are you being serious?
It was crazy.
Was it a loud one?
No.
A smelly one?
The smelliest fart of...
Oh, so you didn't react?
The steeniest...
No, I was like... Well, Will's also a fart terrorist, so wait, I didn't feel that bad.
Right. I am not. That is...
You're a fart terrorist.
I used to be.
You're... Dude, it's chemical warfare.
Yeah, on purpose.
We'll be like, come over here and just fart.
No, I did that once.
You've done it hundreds of
times. No, I did that once when we first started working here. I trapped you in the pantry.
Yeah, you did.
And then you made it my personality.
No, you do it all the time.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
That's actually like
you
such
a
lot.
You stand up and fart and you go, sorry. Ooh, that stinks. That's what you do. You go, ooh, that stinks. Sorry. Sorry, I farted.
Sometimes, yeah, when I fart, I do that.
No, you fart.
But you're acting like I poop my pants all the time.
Pretty much, dude.
That's so fucked up.
I'm like the type of person that I will like respectfully, if I can, like walk to the other side of the room and do it.
Oh, yeah. I don't care about that.
No, that's like the worst. That's like the meanest
thing. I don't care about other human beings. I want everyone I want everyone to sit in my stink.
Dude, your name is a stink zone. Kids never held in the fart. On a plane.
That's wrong.
Nothing funnier than farting on a plane.
Farting on a plane is like... it's a relief because you know that no matter what, no one's gonna know it's you.
Dude, over Thanksgiving, I farted so bad at my grandma's house, my whole family turned on me. They were like actually upset.
What'd they say to you?
They were just calling me a pig and an animal.
They say you're not worth it.
Maybe stay under the deck for the night.
You're a junk guy. You're not worth it.
They put out a fucking copper bowl and just put like Cheerios and different liquids in there.
Cheers and boons.
Capri Suns.
Please send this.
I'm trying.
We'll find it later.
Do you get so fucking mad at me?
We'll find the fart video later.
Wait, why?
Because then we can move on.
You don't want to break it down right now? I just recovered it from my deleted videos, but now I can't find it in my camera roll.
All right, play my cracker while we'll...
Your cranter.
Your cranter.
Yeah, you can mute it. You can mute it. You can mute it. You can mute it.
Dude, this guy's a beast.
Yeah. It's a guy at a skate park.
That's just a good dad right there.
Cart, or what do you call those? Carriage? Carriage with his two sons in it, just doing...
A stroller.
Stroller. And he's just crushing at a skate park, going up and around.
Yeah, we call that a good-ass dad where I'm from.
Is that another grunter?
Yeah.
Wait, you have a nunter grunter?
Yeah. Liam has three grunters today.
No, you don't.
Lies!
Fired up.
I was just waiting for Will to shut the fuck
up. Oh, Will, you should see this one. This guy's awesome.
Yo, Emily, I hate when you talk to me like that.
Oh, cool.
Yo, are we cool?
Oh, so.
Yeah, Bonder, are we cool?
How are you? How was your weekend?
Bonder, are we cool?
Only if you get me on Love Island with your clout.
We don't have enough clout to get you on Love Island.
Are you crazy?
Okay, playing Liam's Crunter. Pay attention, Will.
That's good.
Why do I feel that's like his stomps awesome. Are a lot louder than...
That's exactly how I feel on stage during stand-up.
This is not my observation. I saw this online. I can't remember who. But it's like when someone's playing guitar and using the harmonica, it's like, oh my God, this guy's a genius, like mastermind. But when we see people doing this and drums, we're like, this guy's a circus freak.
Yeah, where is it from? I know. Have we talked about that before?
No, it was... It's. I can't... Someone funny.
Stomp. That was a symbol behind his back.
Yeah, he's got a lot going on, dude. And there's no way I could visually break this down for you audio onlys, and I wish I could.
Would you like to do your third and final crunter?
Yeah, I got one more in there.
Yeah, I got one more in him.
Oh, this one's cash. I don't even know what to say.
I can't do this, Liam. We're going to get copyrighted.
You don't need to. It's just a guy bumping into some tunes.
Oh, the song really does make it, though.
Yeah. That's what I'd be posting on Facebook.
I like live for grandparents who look at their phones like that when you like call them on FaceTime. Have you been watching the Olympics at all?
No.
I have not. Hath you?
I wasn't until I went home this weekend to my parents. That's the only thing they had on. There's a lot of attractive men on there, I will say. Okay. But
yeah, they're also really good at what they do.
Yeah, you got to treat them like meat. That's disgusting.
No, they're insane. Like the synchronized diving is insane. How the fuck do you not only able to do this 5 million flip dive, but synchronize it exactly to the person next to you? And the way they like
training, hard work, dedication.
But, like, it's so weird because they both have like different runs to the front of the. Like diving board, like they each take different amount of steps to
willpower,
to get to the same place. It's crazy.
Sacrifice,
finesse.
The guy whose dick and nuts were too big. What country is he from?
I forget. But did you see the video of it?
Yeah, his cock is fucking.
You're not supposed to look at the video, Leo.
No, I just saw it in general.
Oh, did you see the video, Will?
Sure.
I literally hate you more than anything in this world.
Is he Italian? That's got to be a nice thing, though. Like, even if you lose, at least everyone's talking about how big you are. God, he's so big.
He's French.
That'd be weird. I wouldn't want to deal with that.
With everyone talking about how big you are?
With, like, I mean, think about, like...
Well, you're so big.
Yeah, but, like, family and friends are seeing that.
Yeah, that sucks.
You think I'm big?
Dude, I know you're big.
When's the last time we compared?
It's been over a year. We should do it again.
Yeah. Me and Max compared once when I first met him. I was hammered at the bar and he was peeing. I should not have done this.
This is real?
Yeah, this is real. Well, we didn't compare. I'm exaggerating.
But you took a look.
No.
You looked at us.
No. He was at the urinal and I think it was in Minnesota. It was like on the college tour. Mm-hmm. It's like one of the only stops he came out to. And I didn't know him that well. And he was peeing in the urinal. And I just.
Max Barrett?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just pulled up next to him and started peeing.
Just so he could see you?
I was like, hey, buddy.
Dude, what the hell?
I didn't know him at all.
What the hell?
Yeah, we bonded over it.
You knew Max by the fucking college.
Not that well.
I guess how.
Not enough to.
To show him.
To pull my penis out in front of him and pee with him.
Yeah, that's.
But that's a guy thing.
What is?
Peeing on each other.
Yeah, a little bit.
That's what we do.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to see this video.
It's not that funny. Okay, just for context, the fart has already happened, and Liam goes, "Ooh, that's a stinky one." And I go, "Let's just try to get through here." I can play the audio of that part. I just didn't want to include the actual audition.
Yeah, true.
So let me
we can't do that.
No, we can't. But let me play just that part where Liam's like, "I farted." Okay, this is Liam earlier in the video.
Oh my god, this fart is horrible.
What?
This fart is horrible. It's gonna hit you in the middle of this.
All right. Like,
what?
Shint.
I couldn't help.
Ready?
I dropped a shint. Okay, and this is in the middle of it. I'm going for the window because it's the first. It's the only place I saw fresh air.
Dude, yeah.
This is so funny.
It was crazy.
I felt like I was literally drowning and I was swimming toward the surface.
Dude. Yeah.
It was, dude, it felt like the room turned like a different color.
The way you just hid in the curtains. Like,
dude, you know when like a fart comes out over the human body temperature, like the internal? That thing came out like 117 degrees.
I could tell.
Dude, yeah.
It singed my eyebrows.
Dude, yeah. It was.
I look like I have alopecia after you farted in that room.
Dude, it was crazy. It burnt my ass.
It was hot. My eyes started watering. Crazy. Anyways. How fun is this? I'm like, it's like, Angus is like getting pretty comfortable doing the podcast now. He's just like sitting weird.
I like it.
One day I'm going to have my shoes off when I do it. Mm. People will be like, dang, he's actually getting pretty comfortable behind the mic, behind the camera. And kind of impressive. Like he has so much confidence.
I thought of a sketch that maybe is too hack or too niche, but I was talking to some surfer bros in Hawaii. And they were like, yeah, we're going down to gas chambers later to rip some swells. And I said, that's what it's called. They're like, yeah, it's just like one of this little part of the beach. They call that gas chambers. Just thought it would be really funny if just different.
Different interpretations of what that meant.
Yeah. I was like, how the swells today? They're like, oh, it's got a little morning sickness out there. They all have fucking terms for everything. And they're all weird and they don't make any sense. I asked them to explain it. It doesn't help at all. I felt kind of left out. I'm not going to lie to you.
Yeah, so I mean, they're surfers.
I didn't understand, so that turned into anger, which turned into hatred.
Which turned into let me make fun of them online.
Yeah, which is not what I want.
It's the natural life cycle of feeling.
Yeah.
A negative feeling. Mm. I mean, dude, that's just like, what people don't understand is like, that's how you and I like work shit out in our head. That's how you, like, that's our therapy is like doing sketch comedy. It's like doing funny shit. Like, that's how you and I like, that's how like you and I see clearly. That's like, kind of like our, like, I don't know, like Beethoven would like play the piano and he was fucking nasty at it. Like, that's how he would like, that was like how he would channel like his feelings. Like, we just do it different. Like, we channel it in like sketch comedy.
I think he said it best.
It's ain't making all it fun. Personally.
Do you want to do a guided meditation and get the hell out of here?
Nope.
Okay.
I do. So did anyone want to ask my opinion? Oh, Bill Belly's out.
Yeah, shut up, bitch. This is the new buzzer.
Yeah, that is the new buzzer.
All right, Emily, start talking.
Hello, hello, hello.
Now squeeze it.
No, it's you. Emily, start talking.
Hello, 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 hello. Hi.
What do I do?
It's the buzzer.
Oh, I have to hit it.
You have to hit it really hard.
Ready?
All right, Emily, start talking about Love Island.
So I honestly think that Love Island would be a great...
That's the
new buzzer. So now going forward, this will be our method. Just go on about Love Island. Actually talk about it.
No, because I actually want to go on Love Island. I really do.
You have to wait for my signal. This is the bat signal.
Okay.
Okay, so go talk. Start talking.
I just think it would be a fun show for me to go on because I feel like if I...
And maybe I make a noise too. Try it one more time.
Okay, maybe I should go on a different show like The Bachelor.
I didn't mean to actually spit, but
people did want
that. Yeah, well, it's going to dry up, and now my belly hairs are going to be hard and stiff.
They always are. I forgot to shave my nipples before I went to Hawaii, and my body's already fucking disgusting and white.
You shave your nipples?
I have to.
Why?
It's just like, it just looks weird. It's the only hair on my torso, and it's just like full-blown eyelashes around my nipples.
Anyone else remember that episode of My Name is Earl where he has to shave his nipples?
No, never seen that show. I should watch
it. Someone out there listening just got it and went, is so happy I made that connection.
Is it weird that I shave my nipples? Do you shave your nipples?
Occasionally.
If I had like chest hair and other hair going on, I would, but it's literally the only hair on my torso, so no, it's very off-putting.
You know me and my...
See, that looks normal. Mine literally go around it like eyelashes, and they fold, it looks like eyeballs. It's really unsettling.
Well, you know me and my arm hair problems, so I'm not...
True.
Werewolf.
True, it's like a tarantula.
Mm.
Well, I don't... Guys, we don't really have any right now.
And when I get scared, my nipple hairs stand up.
Mm-hmm. It's a natural defense mechanism. Your body gets nerdness.
Like a pufferfish?
You get nerdness, Emily?
I do get nerdness.
I could shoot him out like a porcupine.
I get more nerdness than I think most people do.
Yeah.
Do you?
I think so.
I think I get equally as nerd.
I think I need nerdness candy. I think I need like nerdness candy and... yeah.
Like Xanax?
Yeah, I think I need like nerdness candy.
Yeah.
You know what nerdness candy we have?
Hmm.
CBDMD.
Speaking of nerdness candy, this collaboration is brought to you by CBDMD. Millions of people experience burnout daily, leading to stress. That he's burning out right now. CBDMD offers a diverse range of products specifically designed to support sleep, focus, and recovery, providing the perfect solution to combat daily stressors. With CBDMD, you can unwind, relax, and get the restful sleep you need. I'll tell you what, I wish I had one right the fuck now. Visit CBDMD.com to explore their full range of products expertly formulated to help you feel your best. CBDMD conducts rigorous, and I mean rigorous, third-party lab testing on all of its products.
Like, it's big guys in suits and big guys in lab coats.
It's so rigorous.
It's like how do you get through that? Well, you have to know your stuff. You have to tighten up.
Each product is accompanied by a certificate of analysis, a COA, if you will, on their website that verifies its potency and ensures its free-form contaminants.
And just to be clear, they don't give this to anybody.
No.
I mean, it's like guys in suits and guys in lab coats.
Yeah. And they ensures that it's free from contaminants such as... pesticides, heavy metals, and molds.
Heavy metals? Wait, but I love Metallica.
And as always, you can use the promo code Friday for 30% off plus free shipping at CBDMD.com, okay?
How'd you memorize all that?
Mental health care is important to me, and this is important to me. And so I want you guys to really you fucking listen to me.
Yeah.
Stop skipping ahead to ads, dude. Sit in the moment with us for God. We get an hour a week, and you're going to fucking skip through the ads? Piece of shit.
I probably need to work on my mental health.
I need to work on my mental health, too.
If anyone comments about me needing Nerdness candy, ban them.
If anyone comments and wants to...
Jarvis, ban them.
Nerdness candy, let me know. All right, can you do a meditation?
Play some music.
Wait, can we put on the headphones? And have the music play through the headphones, Emily? That's smart, yeah. I think that would make me feel pretty good.
Close your eyes.
Mm.
And now open... your pineal gland, your third eye. You've just opened the eye in the center of your brain, and it's red. Hues of orange, yellow, gray, purple, and pink. You see a mountain in the distance. Mm. Sun sets over it. Purple streaks flow through the mountain's caverns, through the spaces in between. Pine trees swaying the wind in different directions, because the wind is coming in from all over, from the east, from the west, from the north.
You hear the wind as it whistles between the whispering pines.
Wake up.
You can't escape forever.
Stop running.
You get nervous, but at the same time, you completely submit all future, past, and present feelings to the ever-blowing wind.
You feel as if your body's turned into one muscle. No bones. Just a hamstring. Contracting. Flexing. Floating.
You become porous. You become liquid. Like an octopus, you pour yourself through the pores in the land, starting to drip through the crust of the earth, like water slowly dripping through a thick towel, dripping toward the center of the earth, like a melting, melting animal.
There's a burning bush in front of you. It burns as if the flames are waves, crashing, white foam pouring in as the oxygen fills the water. But the water, it looks like flames now. A boat emerges, floating through the atmosphere, a sailboat. On the side of it, it says your name and the date you were conceived.
You swim toward the sailboat. You climb onto it. A man with no face, no mouth, no nose, no eyes points a finger at you, and he says, "You have to forgive yourself."
But you say, "I don't know who I am."
And he says, "I know.
I know.
I know.
I know."
You wake up in the woods, staring at your car. The trunk is open. A man is tied up.
Tied down.
You're holding a weapon.
He's wriggling. The ropes are loosening. You have to do something.
You reach toward his mask. You say, "What have I done? Where am I?" You pull off his mask.
It's you.
It's you.
You're the man. You've done this to yourself, as you've done in every life you've ever lived. Over and over. The cycle only ends and starts with you.
You hear the wind whistle through those whispering pines again. The only constant in your life, the unwavering, unpredictable wind. You submit yourself to the entropy of God's creation.
You look down at your arms. You're made of bark. Smooth. Smooth bark. A bird lands on your shoulder. A raven looks at you and its third eye opens.
A family of birds starts to collect on your branches. The mother says to the children, "This will be our home, children. I will foster you here. I will nurse you here. You will grow here, and you will one day depart from here, but this will always be your home." And as she explains this, you hear a rumbling. You turn to look, but no matter how hard you try, you are stuck. A tree, forever rooted in the ground there, but you hear the rumbling getting closer and closer. And the mother says, "No, no, they're back." And you hear a vehicle coming, a large rumbling. Beep, beep, beep. All the trees in the forest struggling, screaming to turn, but none can move, and they're fated to be stuck there, rooted there for eternity.
Eternity. You look down, you unbutton your blouse. You have six nipples long, as long as your middle finger, but thicker. Just then, hummingbirds come. They feed off your nectar. "Not too much," you say.
Feels good, like you're nursing them to health. But as you watch the hummingbirds fly away, they turn to black goo, black bile, and drop in the air like a rock.
"What have you done?
How could you?
You've poisoned my children."
"I didn't know. I didn't know."
"Yes, you did."
You turn, a familiar voice. A man with no face, no nose, no eyes, no mouth, no ears, no torso, just a floating, faceless head. And he screams at you,
"You did this."
And you scream back,
"What?"
Another man comes out. He crawls down the tree head first, defying gravity. Like a squirrel, his fingers grip into the bark. And he says, "It begins now. Again. It begins again now."
And you say, I just started. I just rooted myself here. I just grew so tall, taller than the other trees stretching toward the sun. I just started depositing seeds around me, and as you scream and cry, the wind picks up and roars and shakes you. The power of God shakes you, and little seeds start to fall. One of the seeds passes right by your face, and you notice that seed, it has a face. Who is that? And then you realize,
it's me.
It's me.
And the wind picks up even harder. And as the wind passes through, it strips away the color from the green leaves, the green grass, the red volcanic soil. It all strips away and becomes gray again. And finally you can start fresh. But in the back of your mind, you know, there's nothing you can do to change. Thank you for listening to this podcast. And we hope you have a wonderful weekend. God bless you and Godspeed. Touch them up, gentlemen. Back to your corners.